Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Farming Simulator 15 on Mulroy Bay, where technical issues have meant that some stuff has gone on off camera. Technical issues meaning my microphone has been disconnecting again and it's getting really annoying, and I really need to fix that. If it happens again, I'll take a small break and fix it. Blah, 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 blah. Actually had probably close to a complete episode recorded when I checked my raw files folder and discovered that none of the footage actually existed because Fraps corrupted it all when my mic crashed. Or when my mic disconnected, or whatever the hell my mic is doing, and I'm getting really frustrated at it. Because it only ever seems to happen when I'm recording, which is wonderful. Can I refill the trailer? I can refill the trailer from the sea. Free water forever. Oh, I can also show you this funny little glitch I found. The infinite reflection. I'm not entirely sure that's intended. But it is comical. And it happens in every mirror. That's just... I'm pretty sure that's a bug, and I'm not sure if it's with the game or caused by the map. But whatever's causing it, that is freaking hilarious. So... okay, I best explain what happened in the episode that you'll never see because the video files got corrupted. I sold off the canola. I made money and bought a water trailer. There you go. I spoke about some stuff as well, but I'm not going to rehash stuff that I've, in my mind, have already spoken about. Hooray! So, I have absolutely no plans for these episodes, so this is just me going off the cuff and deciding what to do as I go along. Which isn't necessarily the best idea, because most of my ideas tend to boil down to, oh well, I'll cut some grass! Hooray! No, that's not a good idea, dude. You can't do that all the damn time. I mean, you can, but it stops being entertaining after the 50th cut. Or the third, depending on how much you love grass. And more importantly, what kind of grass you like. So yes, the default in-game water trailer actually does work with the Pigs and Beef mod, which I thought it didn't. Which meant that on Cobra Park Farm, I actually wasted quite a lot of money on a bigger water tanker. And now I'm going to have to go out of here because I need to refill the trailer again because... oh, that was the pigs. I am no longer surprised that they took all of the water. So we got 100 pigs still, 13 at slaughter weight, 7 cows at slaughter weight, which, you know, it's about half. Nuts. That hill just gets more and more irritating every time I go down it. So instead of going back into town, I'm going to go over here because there is actually a secondary beach. The first one was just a test to see if I could get the water out of the sea, which I now know I can. And if I remember right, there is a way down to the beach itself. Yeah, just hop down this and the new Honda will pull itself out nicely. So I don't think the water here is too deep. It's not ridiculously deep. It's deep enough for me to do this, though. Oh, I am so ridiculously bad at cheating. So... there is one thing I spoke about in the... what I'll call the forgotten episodes that I will mention again. Videos might be a bit odd in the near future. By that I mean, I might stop doing off camera work for a little while. Some of you who have been around for a long time, quite close to the start of the channel, will know that I have other projects going on. If you've been around long enough, you'll know what those projects are to an extent. Obviously I got the channel and I've got Donesk. I have a third project that is a secret for now, but should be revealing itself in the next couple of months. All going to plan, which it generally hasn't been, which is fun. But yeah, the super secret third project will be hopefully revealed early next year. And there'll be a lot of stuff coming from that, which could mean that videos become even more weird and hectic and almost rushed. I don't want to say rushed entirely because I can't guarantee that I'll allow that to happen. But there is a reasonable chance of videos just becoming a bit odd and there being complete absence of off-camera work in between videos. Reasons for that being, I just won't have enough time. I completely envision myself not having enough time to do off-camera work. Because I still want to work on Donesk, as well as, you know, get videos up for you guys. And Donesk takes a lot more work than videos, so I'm going to give Donesk a bit more time than the videos. And blah, 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 blah. Problems, problems, problems. What do I want to do now? See, this is where my plans fall short because I'm, 7.5 minutes into a 20-minute video and I've just completely run out of things to do because the water went a bit quicker than I'd expected. A lot quicker than I'd expected. I didn't know what I expected. So, let's see. What can I do? What can I do? What can I do? Drunken Sailor. I think, first off, I'm going to get rid of the aggro star because I just never use that. I mean, yes, I could use it for many, many things, but I've got 3 other tractors that I can use regularly. And if I've still got the Hurleyman, for whatever reason, I'm going to get rid of that too, because, again, I've got 3 other tractors that I use very, very regularly. And the plan is planned already. So let's see what I got. We got the Aggro Star, which is going, so we'll turn that on. Do I still have the Hurleyman? No, I do not. So let's get rid of the Aggro Star here. The plan is planned. I don't know if my plan will plan well enough to plan. Yes? You understand? Yes, good. In all seriousness, though, I do have a plan. I don't know if this is going to work. Where is the cell point for vehicles? Because I want to make as much as possible for this plan to work out. Is it back there? No. It's hidden in here somewhere. Ah, there it is. Alright, so let's sell this. 30,600. I don't think I'll have enough. Sewing machines, 52,000. Don't have enough for that. Do I have anything in mods that could potentially work? That's 3 meters, but high capacity, and it is direct seed. Okay, so that's perfect for what I want. So let's go to the garage, and we'll sell off, just from here, the cultivator and the seeder. And we will buy Verstad Rapide, 300C. There we go. And we'll also pay back a bit of the loan. So, why did I just buy that seeder? It's because I've randomly decided that I'm going to seed the fields again in canola. Because canola is money, and money is good. And I do want to try and pay off the loan before I finish up this series. And I will be finishing up quite soon. I've decided I'm going to go to episode 30. And then that's the end of Mulroy. Because I do want to get onto another map. Nussin's going to be staying around for the foreseeable future. Possibly even until Donetsk is done, Nussin will stay. Because there's still quite a lot I want to do there. And this year is going to be potentially problematic. I forgot how long this thing is. Nussin's going to stay because I do like Nussin, and the format I'm using on Nussin actually lends itself to doing a longer form series. And I don't want to do that with every map, because then you'll all get bored of every map. That field is just going to be abandoned now, because that is just too small to do anything with. Where are the seeds though? In here. In here? And there we go, and let's reverse in. And the comedy is, I'm probably going to only record the one episode today, because things are probably going to go a bit hectic. And in fact, I'm going to nip off for a second for you guys, for a little while longer for me, so I'll be right back. And I am back. Sorry about that. I needed to run away and do something reasonably quickly. So, we're going to plant canola pretty much everywhere I can plant canola. And now that I know that... Oh, I'm dead again. Lovely! Now that I know that the auto combine does in fact work occasionally, which is most of the time, to be fair, it just doesn't tend to work on the first pass, which is fine. I'm going to unfold this thing, and now it can turn on, and now I can lower it once I get to a point in the field where I'm comfortable lowering it, which is there, and away we go now, seeding, and this is probably going to be the next episode as well, because I don't have anything else. I don't actually have anything else I can do. Much less that I want to do. I know I could go into forestry, but I don't want to be taking out I don't want to be maxing out the loan again. I don't really want to need to get a forestry trailer or such, so this is pretty much all I can do for now. And I do apologize for the inconvenience that this may cause. Especially if you're not a big fan of watching me crawling around the field at like 10 kilometers an hour on it. Because here's a fun fact, I am actually terrible at seeding. This game in general. It's actually why I'm doing the more kind of more realistic style series on Nussin, is I want to get better at the game, and Nussin does seem to be helping. That's also why I've got the wheel and joysticks on. Actually, I want to get a bit more immersion, which is why I got the wheel and joystick. Nussin is just to kind of get better at the game in general. Which is funny, because I rag on giants a lot. I know I do. And that's not from me hating giants or hating the game. It's me knowing that giants can do so much better. Which I think everybody knows they can, and giants just not. Giants haven't really improved the game as such over 2013. Yes, there are small graphical improvements and whatnot, but it's not a whole new game compared to 2013. Even now, with Gold Edition out, it's still not that much better than 2013 was. And with modding, I would say the modding community, but it's the community at large just going out of control and essentially imploding. The American community especially, which has all but disappeared now, apparently due to the actions of a small group of individuals who I don't know. what I've been told, it's a small group of individuals has essentially caused the American farm sim community to disintegrate. Is probably the best word for it. Which is a shame. I'm seeing the same thing happen on FSUK and mod host, or, you know, good modders are going away because it looks like giants aren't doing anything to improve the game, which I would agree with to a large extent. The community is just as bad, and the community is just as much blame. And as much as I hate to admit, I'm possibly part of the problem. I know that I rag on mods quite a lot, and people, well, mod authors especially, don't like that, but I do try and give constructive criticism where I can. If a mod is just plain terrible, like, to give an example, the Porsche Cayman S, which was just bad. I know the mod author doesn't want to hear somebody say, you know, your mod is just plain bad. It's, you know, pretty much everything about it needs to change, and you know, your skills aren't quite what you thought they were. Blender skills, really on point, but that Porsche was just bad as a mod. There are some upsides, and I will give the upsides. Now that I've kind of briefly, by my standards, spoken about, you know, what's up with Farm Sim and why is it in a bad state right now. Honestly, I think the private modding, I know that I'm definitely part of this problem. The private modding thing is an issue, but I do mod edits, which is different. I know I've edited this map, so it's a private map now. The Nussan I use is also private because I've edited it and I don't want to talk to Vittori, so apparently he's quit modding, which is lovely. But yeah, the edits I do are for my own personal use, and that's the whole point. You can do the same edits, they're quite simple. If I can do them, you can do them. And quite frankly, if I can make a map, anybody can make a map. Because I'm not particularly good at Giants Editor. I'm improving. I know I'm improving, because now a single road piece doesn't take me 20 minutes to put in. It takes me like 2 minutes, and then I realize an hour later with, you know, 15, 20 extra road pieces in that, oh, I've screwed up, you know, an hour ago, and they'll never line up ever. Guess what I've been doing on Donetsk recently? 30 centimeters too high and probably a meter and a half off horizontal. Grumble, grumble, grumble. I'm actually rebuilding the road from the point that it all kind of goes wrong. From the point where it meets the road, I'm hoping the lane will kind of repair itself in a way. That's one of the joys of modding, is you get stuff wrong. Sometimes it's, you know, it works out in your favor and things unexpectedly go right and better than you'd expected, but a lot of the time it's, oh, here's a problem I didn't expect. Or, you know, stuff like that, and you just, moments like that where you realize that half the fun of modding is getting it wrong and wondering how on earth you managed to get it so wrong. But, I get why people prefer private mods. It's a lot less hassle, to an extent. I get why a lot of mod authors are going down that route. I know that I've already mentioned it. Somebody's already asked where Donetsk is going to be released. Donetsk isn't even playable yet. Don't ask for release dates or anything. I know people want, you know, updates on mods and maps when they're being created. That's why I'm doing the Donetsk series. The Donetsk series. When I get a significant amount of progress made, you probably won't see a Donetsk video for a week or two at this point. But when I get a significant or at least reasonable amount of progress made, where I can say, hey, look, this is done, I'm going to move on to the next thing. Yeah, that's when you'll get a video. And I might do something funky over the next couple weeks if I've got time. But that's when you're going to get a video, is when there has been at least some progress made. And right now there has been quite a bit of progress made, but it's very slow, fiddly progress. Which is really irritating for me. Because I am quite impatient. Much and all as I don't show up in videos, I am a quite impatient person in general, and there are times when I'll just stop doing the desk for 2 hours and watch a video instead. Just to cool off. But, you know, I'm seeing not big issues, and I'm not saying that any of you guys who watch and comment regularly do it, but I'm starting to see people saying, oh well, but I have seen people, one person say, well, when, you know, when's this being released? Your guess is as good as mine, buddy. I've no idea how long it's going to take. If I had to guess, early 2016. Early to mid 2016, probably around the same time as the Homer DLC. Donesk will be dropping, because I will take I will, like last year, do Christmas special and kind of go all out in videos for a couple of weeks to get ahead so that I can take a few days away from Farm Sim the game, and the aim of that is to get progress made on Donesk, and I'm probably going to do that reasonably regularly, is just record 2 weeks of videos in 1 week or a week and a half or whatever, and get them all ready to go and get them all uploaded, and then just work on Donesk for a week solid. You know, it's just that kind of stuff that there are times when Donesk gets in the way of YouTube, and there's times when YouTube gets in the way of Donesk, and it's really a hard balance to strike. And I think I'm going to leave this video here, because I think it's about 20 minutes over the two parts. Probably a bit over. I tend to just go through videos and be like, hey, get it, go in like 5 minutes. I better speed up what I'm doing, or delay what I need to do, you know, hour long. This time I couldn't, it was completely urgent. Actually had to be done. So I'm going to leave this video here, and I don't know when I'll be recording the next episode of Mulroy, because I've got a few other things I need to do that I've kind of put off until I had this video done, and gonna run off and do them now, and make myself a cup of tea, because that's what I do when I do those other things. Other things meaning I need to do the dishes in the kitchen before my mother gets home. And I kind of decided to do a video, maybe two, because of technical issues and whatnot. It ended up being just the one. So, yeah. This single half is going to be like half an hour. Oh, Lord. I am terrible at timekeeping. This video is as long as it is. The Christmas video this year will be on a map. I don't know what map. Might well be Nostan, where I just do... If you watched last year's, number one, you've been here for damn near a year already, and congratulations, you're amazing. Number two, you'll remember it was, I think it was an hour long, if memory serves, on Westbridge Hills, which was the only map I was doing at the time. I'll have to see what day Christmas falls on. Also, Map and Mod Spotlights will be taking a break, possibly for most of December. I don't know what's going to replace them. It's probably going to be an extra video from Roy and or the short map, which is, this isn't This is going to sound odd, but I don't count this series, Mulroy, as it currently is, with my main series. I count Nustin as my main series on the channel. So if I start doing extra videos of this, it's just a secondary series. Nustin's the main series because I've actually got a bloody storyline going in it. Somewhat. And it's fun when I find problems with mods that pretty much require to be taken out of the series, because then I gotta try and think up a storyline reason to do it. It's actually harder than it sounds to, you know, say, oh well, this mod's got an error that I really don't like, or in the case of the Deutz, which I am getting rid of possibly tomorrow. Depends on things. In the case of the Deutz, that was reasonably easy, because the reason I'm getting rid of it, number one, the dirt skin I just don't like. I will keep the mod. I'm just going to get rid of it off the farm, off the map. The reason I'm getting rid of it is, number one, I don't like the dirt skin, which is reasonable because it is a bit of a mess. And number two, there are a couple of relatively small errors that need to be fixed. So, the storyline reason is the engine has bad emissions and whatnot. So, I'm keeping them on because at some point I might potentially decide, you know what, I'm going to try and fix this mod. I'm going to try and get rid of the error, going to get a normal on the dirt skin to give it the look of actual dirt. I'm going to darken down the dirt skin. Figure out how on earth to get rid of it on the inside of the tractor, because that looks atrociously bad. I know giants have, for whatever reason. I only know this from watching David Oldfield. They, for whatever reason, started putting dirt skins on the inside of tractors now. With the Z-horse. I don't know if that was intentional, but I do know that's a thing. Also, I have heard, again, through David Oldfield, who I don't talk to. I watch his videos quite a lot. That the Gold Edition is bugged to high hell. All of the tractors are bugged. Woo. The combines, they've done something weird with the reference paths in Giant's Editor. And the Lewis, and that's kind of bugged the combines a bit. Oddly, the Neva is the only one that does work, and that was the free bonus. The map, I think everybody knows by now, the cows essentially become statues after a period, because giants have managed to screw up the cow nav meshes. You know, the nav meshes that they created and that they use for maps. I have never seen a bigger Foster clock than Gold Edition. Between the Steam release and the absolute mayhem that is what Giants have done, you know, what Giants are trying to fix now, I have never seen a bigger issue. I've rarely seen games with as many problems. Anyway, this is going to be a half hour long video. Enjoy! I'm going to leave it here. I got carried away seeding and talking again. I'm going to leave it here. Thank you all very, very much for watching. Until next time, stay safe and goodbye!